What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Cool Colas here, and I have another interesting video for y'all to check out. But before we get into it, I would like for y'all to do a few things for me. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Go ahead and hit that like button. Go ahead and hit that share button. And also follow me at Cool Colas on Instagram. That way you get all the latest and greatest updates when it comes to my channel and everything that I have going on, and you can follow me on my journey as well too. Today, I want to talk about a topic that I found to be pretty interesting because I always see people share quotes about this on social media, either in their stories, in their posts, in their reels, trying to give advice. A lot of times it comes off kind of passive aggressive, but sometimes I think people are well-meaning and they're really just trying to help others out. But I want to talk about my perception on this topic. Today, we're going to break down why forgiveness is overrated. And specifically, we're going to be breaking down why it's overrated in terms of black people. So we'll be looking at the basic definition of it, but we'll also be looking at why, when it comes to black people, this is a term that, or this is a phrase that sometimes can be very problematic. Now, when we think about forgiveness, or at least when I think about forgiveness, the first thing that comes to mind is the synonym for forgiveness, which is to excuse. This is a problem for me personally. I don't like to excuse things that are wrong. I like to address and correct things that are wrong. And I will not accept excusing something that's wrong as a consolation prize for someone not giving in or realizing what is the problem there. To me, that's not a proper way to address problems and to address issues, which is why me personally, I kind of struggle with this idea of forgiveness itself. Beyond what I'm about to tell you when it comes to black people. So just the simple idea that excuse is a synonym for that just doesn't sit right with me. But when I thought about this term, I had to really think about what is it that I think other people are trying to say that they're not really saying. I think the problem with a lot of people, especially when they're sharing these quotes on social media, is that they're giving advice from the standpoint of not wanting to hear people really, quote unquote, complain, which a lot of times is people just addressing problems or issues that they have, but they don't like to hear people complain. So when people complain about the things that other people do and they continue to hear it over and over again, it begins to be annoying. And I think that what it ends up turning into is an issue where their real problem is they don't like that people dwell on something. They feel like somebody is continuing to recycle this issue over and over and over again. So the real issue with forgiveness and people talking about it is they don't like the idea of having to hear people over and over again dwell on that situation. Now, do I agree that dwelling is an issue? Yes, I do agree that people should not dwell on something to the point where it consumes them and they can't think about other things. However, I wish people would just say that. I wish they would just say the real problem with forgiveness is dwelling and the idea that I really don't want to hear all that over and over again, because I really think that's what people mean when they say that. Now, there are some people who just want better for people and whatnot, but most people, when they say that, are saying it to say basically you're dwelling on something that you should have been got past. That's really what they're saying. And my opinion is, you shouldn't dwell on something. Everybody's timetable for that is different. But forgiveness itself, I struggle with the whole idea of that, because it's not just dwelling. It's the idea of dwelling and excusing, which leads me to my next point, which is that I think a lot of people are really saying to forgive and forget, and they're conflating these two as one thing. Now, I've heard some people separate the two, which is cool, but I think that a lot of times they're including forgetting it. And on top of forgetting, they're also including reconnection into that. So from my perspective, I think that reconnecting with something that is harmful, hurtful, or isn't really sorry is really something that's problematic and counterproductive and non-constructive. And I probably should have said this from the get-go, but when I'm talking about forgiveness and this whole idea of forgiving people, I think that the main issue is that people are having a problem with forgiving people who aren't sorry. So I want to make sure that that context is in there too, and I probably should have said that. It's not about forgiveness when somebody does something wrong and you know you're trying to forgive them and they've apologized for it already, or whatever the case is, and they're actually sorry. This is more about forgiveness when the person is not sorry. You don't excuse things that are from the a standpoint of that person feeling like they didn't do anything wrong, but you know what they did in your mind is actually wrong. I don't necessarily think that that's the most healthy way to go about it. As a matter of fact, I think it's an attempt to be overly sanctimonious when you don't have to. And I definitely think it's overrated right off rip. Because a lot of times when people are talking about this whole concept of forgiveness, it's off rip, like right when somebody does it from the does something wrong from the moment that person feels angry. I don't necessarily agree with that either. As a matter of fact, one thing I've said on social media quite a bit to people, and some people probably didn't like that I said this, is that sometimes we need to hold the big G. What I mean by the big G is sometimes holding a grudge is actually very important. The reason why it's very important is because it helps you to remember the bad, poor, terrible decisions or things that people did to offend or harm or hurt you. To me, sometimes that's very important because it helps you to remember how that person could potentially be, especially in a situation where they're not really sorry and there's then that conversation about forgiveness itself. So sometimes you should hold the big G in certain situations, not all the time, but definitely when there's something that's a real problem that needs to be addressed. Now let's talk about in terms of black people. The issue with black people, specifically foundational black Americans, is that we tend to forgive far too easily and far too soon. We've already forgiven the white supremacists, and they really haven't atoned for absolutely anything. We don't have any tangible laws that protect us. We don't have reparations, and we really are just treated as outcasts in society. We are the worst treated race in society, and we're a permanent underclass as a result of white supremacy and the residual effects of white supremacy, which a lot of them try to ignore, but you know, that's how they always do. The point I'm trying to make, though, is that we forgive too easily because that's just in our spirit. A lot of us as foundational black Americans, we see it as a thing of everybody should love on everybody. We should care about everybody's well-being. It's like the very almost especially for like black women, very nurturing part of them. For black men, it's kind of the will to be able to accept people and still kind of like take them in and stuff like that. It's kind of like taking somebody under your wing still. So I think that we still have that concept of forgiving very easily, which is why we browbeat other people when they're not so forgiving. But I think the problem is that by forgiving, sometimes you're not allowing yourself to actually fight for the things that you should have been given in the first place based off of the things that have been done. Now, that doesn't mean that you seek for somebody to be sorry. Sometimes that means that you need to go about things in other ways where other consequences are given to individuals who don't really try to atone for the mishaps and the misdeeds that they've actually created. So in terms of not even just talking about race, just talking about forgiveness specifically by its lonesome, I think the real issue is that people should just learn how to remove themselves from a situation and not dwell on it, not look back at the conversations that you had with a person. Focus your mind on other things that are important and whatnot. I think that that's more important than just saying, oh, I forgive and we're good. So the next time you see the person, it's all gravy. I don't really think that's realistic or cool, which is why I don't really co-sign that. And I think that when it comes to race relations and the way that the white supremacist has treated black people in general, I don't think there should be some forgiveness anywhere there, because I don't think forgiveness is really deserved. Now, another thing I want to talk about when it comes to the whole concept of race being involved in these little quotes that people love to share on social media is the idea that sometimes people like to conflate concepts. They like to take something that could be generally true for the average person, and they like to equate it to something that deals with race itself. And forgiveness is one of those things. I think that to have a healthy amount of not dwelling on a situation is very important for people in general. So even that's when dealing with something that somebody who's black does to somebody else who's black. I think that it's important to not dwell on things. Not necessarily like forgive, but just to not dwell on things. When it comes to when race is involved, I think that throws a new element in it, meaning that the stance that should be taken is different. In that case, I feel that if you are in a situation where you're asked to forgive a white person for what they've done, I don't agree with that on the simple premise that nothing has been done whatsoever. So there is that need for disconnection, obviously, but there also is that need for that, for you to look at other options to be able to get some type of atonement or compensation for what has been done, which is why a lot of us fight for reparations. A lot of us fight for tangible laws to be created for ourselves and things like that. So from my perspective, forgiveness is overrated to me because it's almost as if it's being equated, conflated, and maybe just mixed in with being able to forget and being able to reconnect or to connect with a stronger bond. And I think a lot of times we need to learn when somebody really doesn't mess with us and they really don't deserve our forgiveness. They deserve our discipline. And they deserve the repercussions that come with being disciplined. Anyway, that's what I got to say about that topic. I hope y'all enjoyed it. If you guys want to hear more from me, feel free to go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the share button, as I said earlier, so you can hear the latest and greatest updates when it comes to my channel. Anyway, y'all, I hope y'all have a good rest of y'all's day, and I'll be talking to y'all soon. Peace.